It was all celebration in Siaya after Colonel Asanga of Orange Democratic Movement was handed the certificate following the just concluded gubernatorial by-elections.
I'll now call upon Amoth Colonel Asanga to hand over the certificate to him. Welcome.
The gubernatorial race gave Asanga an early lead, prompting his closest rival William Oduor of NAP to concede defeat even before the final tally was announced. And after the final vote count, Asanga was clearly the winner, recapturing his seat by over 60% of the total vote cast by garnering 107,737 votes against Oduor's 64,121 votes.
Democracy is at stake because today we are seeing democracy working again as it had worked earlier. So
Oduor, who successfully challenged Rasanga's election in the March 4th general elections, drew in the towel, promising to work hand in hand with the governor-elect. It was the same script, different cast in Kibwezi constituency, after independent candidate Patrick Musimba recaptured his parliamentary seat, trouncing his closest contender Kalembe Ndile in a neck-to-neck race.
My ambitions are solely about getting our people to be united and to deal with our issues. If we can have another third, fourth generation Patrick Musimbas, then we are heading places as a community.
Musimba garnered 17,103 votes against Kalembe's 16,928 votes. But Kalembe was not taking the defeat lightly, hinting of another possible court battle.
Akawa ananifuata na 415. Zilo yalikuwa ameweka kwa screen, ukiongeza zangu 620, zinakuja 1725. Ukiongeza zake, zinakuja hiyo 17103. So unaona bado sahi nawekewa 169 something. Where is 107? Na ukijaribu kumuuliza, hataki kujijibu. Anasema tutaondolewa nje. You know, anataka tukasirike ndio kuwe fujo vitu ina hiyo. Lakini hatutampei nafasi. So let me go to our tallying center because we have ours also. Tuende tunajaribu kukusanya hizi from 35. Na akiendelea vile anaendelea kitaka kutangaza, nimwambie pia tukutane tena kotini.
Kalembe accused IBC officials of malpractices, saying the provisional results did not tally. But it was all smile for Musimba, who promised to develop the semi-arid constituency. Anthony Kaikai reporting for Channel 1 Lunchtime News.